Yo, what is up, guys? This is Javier, and welcome back to another Path of Exile video. Check this out. Holy shit. It only took like fucking 5 months to get delivered from New Zealand to Hungary. It's like actually crazy. But today I want to talk about a low investment, low maintenance strategy that I'm working on. It's like the good old Beyond and Breach and Choose Everything, right? So I will talk about the Atlas 3, I will talk about everything else, but as for now, all you need to do that I'm doing: cemetery maps, chisel, alk, and wall orbit. Since my build can run all of the modifiers, I don't really care about the outcome. Unless it turns into another map, then I just toss it out, right? As for the scarabs, I'm using Polished Breach, Polished Legion, Rusted Harpy, and Rusted Carto. Now the Carto, you can like, it's like a flex pick. You can put like ambush or whatever else that you'd like, right? So I'm just using Carto because like I had some in my stash and I wanna get rid of them, right? So the last one is like a super flex pick, right? So I'm gonna do 50 maps. Originally I wanted to do 30, but it turns out that I'm clearing these maps like super fast, and so here are some stuff that I've already like tossed out. And yeah, 50 maps. I'm gonna catch you guys once I'm done with the 50 maps and break it down how much money you can make if you invest 13c in a map, right? So yeah, catch you guys later. All right, so while I'm at it, let's talk about the Atlas passives. So there are a few key things that you will definitely pick up on your Atlas. I'm actually missing three points. I'm gonna get them later, but for that 3 points you would take this these three nodes, right? So we are using Enduring Influence, one more extra sextant use. It's super good since we are using sextants on our voice stones, or voice stones, I would say. So that's like a no-brainer. This is a huge one, Shadow of Hunger. It gives us the altars. The altars are basically the backbone of this strategy. The altars can give us scarabs. It can give us quant and rarity on our map. And Eldritch currency. So this is like super important note to pick up, right? Legion, we are taking Legion because we are running Legion also. Include generals, more emblems, emblematic, 0.6 chance to drop an emblem itself instead of splinters. Don't be fooled. 0.6% chance is fucking huge. I've got a lot of emblems just because of this. So this is actually like super important. Breach, same goes here. And drops breach stones instead of normal things. Again, Legion, extra rewards for Legion. Breach again. Breach bosses drop double splinters, that is huge also. Harbinger, increase cooldown recovery rate. That means that basically it does the summoning faster, so it's just less time spent on the harbingers. Breach again, increase monster density, huge. Harbinger, so the powerful Harbinger Bros is the big guy accompanied by the few little Harbingers. This is like you get your exalted shards and whatnot from the Harbinger boss, right? The powerful Harbinger boss. Besides that, we are taking essences, like extra tiers. We are taking strong boxes. Strong boxes are super good for divines and whatnot, right? Extra Harbinger, like guaranteed extra Harbinger, one extra shrine, strong boxes, essences, choosing, basically, and beyond. We are taking two beyond wheels. I was thinking about picking this one up, but that's for a later strategy that I want to try. And again, extra pack size for influence mobs. So it's like kind of a simple SS3, I would say. And for the money that you can actually make from it is like super, super good, right? So that's pretty much about the SS passives. And I'm back. 50 maps. Done. Over. So I'm gonna silence the voting. However, first I'm gonna take out the maps, because like I know silence doesn't count for the maps, and I got a few conqueror maps and whatnot. We need to manually add it up, so I'm just gonna sort this thing out and silence the voting after, right? And we are done. So, one thing to note is that I took out 25 cemetery maps and we are still left with 38. That means that we got over 60 cemetery maps. That means that we actually oversustained our map pool. Now, that's the reason why I did not include cemetery map prices for the calculations. And yeah, keep in mind that I use Cartus Scarabs, although I just use the cheap ones, but I am fairly positive that you can sustain your map pool without a Cartus Scarab. And we have, what's that, 48, 60 something maps left, right? So I'm not even gonna include these in the pricing, but that's like 100 on top of everything else, right? Now, again, we have a few extra things that the Exiles cannot price check for us, and that is maps, right? So we have 3 Guardian maps, that's like 30C, and we have 4 Blighted maps, that's like 60C right there, and we have 1 Conqueror map, that is like 35 to 40C, so that is one extra exalt, I would say, that we can just add this up, right? Now, for the big part. How much money did we make? So we made close to 3,000 chaos, right? Now, I'm just gonna double check. Okay, there is no Blighted map. There is no Conqueror map. Nothing like this, right? So, again, with the calculations, as I said, we are spending 13C on each map. That is, with a few cheap scarabs, 5C on the map device and a vacant sextant. It comes down to 12.5 and we are chiseling, we are arcing, we are walling. It's like 13C. So that means that overall we spent 650. We need to get rid of this in order to actually get the right number. And we have the, or I should say, we have the one extra exalt that we can add to this, right? With the maps that we have left with, right? Now then again, Exiles does not give the most accurate calculations, because it cannot count for bulk selling, for example, and we have quite a lot of essences. That's like, usually it's like 25% extra, but then again, sometimes it calculates different things for less or more. It basically evens itself out, right? Now, so that means that in Exalt, with the current prices, we made 18.7, close to 19 Exalt. Now, I'm not gonna include time or money per hour with this, right? The reason being that if you have a bow character, Lightning Arrow or Tornado Shot or whatever, you can be faster. If you have a silver character that can still do it, then that's that. Like your money per hour gonna like, it's gonna influence your money per hour, right? For me, it was around 5 hours. If I were to divide that, that's like 4 exalts an hour, doing basically no prep, right? So that is really good, I would say, at least for me, especially with the new Atlas passives and whatnot, right? So that's pretty much it. If you happen to enjoy this video, give it a like, it would help me out a ton. And yeah, I talk to you guys very soon.